present time feels, it feels odd. The change in technology, the internet, the speed of stuff that can go out. Someone can make a track now and it can be on their SoundCloud 10 minutes after they've made it. So all that has a massive impact on the gestation period of these musics, which they did have a lot longer before. And I think that's a universal thing. I don't think that's particularly, I don't think the reason that Britain hasn't had a jungle or whatever, or dubstep kind of just was such a peak and a down, I don't think that's anything to do with the music not being able to do that. I just think we're in a different times now, and the music has to deal with it, with its outlets and all the great stuff that it can do now. You hear a tune down the road, you might not even like the tune, and it's in your head all day, you know, da 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 da, whatever. I mean, this is a hallucination. I mean, it's not, you're not humming it to yourself. And there was a lot of stuff I was reading about that at the time. And I was reading something about a thing called a release hallucination, which I think now is Oliver Sacks, the writer Oliver Sacks, the neurologist Oliver Sacks was talking about, which is a common hallucination that people get, which you get, they're also called earworms. My previous work was really, the whole purpose of it was to work out how I could synthesize sounds from nothing, from the computer, within the computer, and just to try and build something out of this machine. Like, what does it sound like? What can I do with this thing, this super high-powered thing? When I started making dance music, or music that hinted at dance music, I guess that kind of just carried through with me, that conceptual framework. I guess my background is more in the arts, I suppose, if you like. So, yeah, but also most of my music collection would be, you know, from the dance music history of where we're from. I'm from a half Irish family, so we have a big family, a Catholic thing. So yeah, so we have quite a large family, and I have a lot of older cousins, and you know, they were listening to stuff, so I would hear a lot of it was tape culture then, you know, you'd hear it in a car, or so they would be listening to what was like early rave stuff then. I have a large collection of tapes from that time, of different stuff, of records, of so, and I always loved the kind of chord sounds in a lot of that music.
Eh oui, l'Angleterre est en proie à une nouvelle poussée de fièvre musicale, 100 ans après la house music, après la techno. Voici venir l'époque de la jungle music. La jungle, une création artificielle, la jungle fait appel aux rythmes électroniques des synthétiseurs, aux platines à disques, où l'on triture des morceaux déjà existants, un fond sonore sur lequel on calque des paroles plus ou moins improvisées.
The reinforced stuff, the early stuff, the Dagger Mark angle. I spent quite a long time going through lots of tapes. And just as soon as I come across a sound that had like a little moment, take the drums out of it and see in a sense if I could retain it as a piece of, as jungle, you know. It was, I guess in a sense, sort of an experiment to see if you could still keep the essence of the music without the things that you think are so important to that music.
Right, safe, right, no, easy, right, no, easy. Yeah, wicked tune there to deal with, man.
Okay. So what's happening with it?
Well, I'm just gonna show you, just building up half key, and I'll just vocal it for you and done.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's have a listen.
Ah ha ha, ooh ho ho, oh ho ho, what a feeling. And we go like this.
You listen to some of the early stuff where they're using samplers, 3 seconds, and it's, I mean, and then you listen to some Music Concrete, and it's the same. It's not that different. It's cut up collage. Tape music, if you like. I definitely went in with the idea of undoing it, taking it to bits and having these parts, and then okay, now it's not that any, now it's not jungle, it's you know, it's broken, it's fallen down the stairs or something. It feels a comfortable area for me, to be honest with you. It doesn't. I don't feel difficult in it. I don't feel difficult making music that sits on both. Someone said to me, from the more contemporary, classical, experimental, Stockhausen-y world, if you like, he said it was strange that music now would be like experimental music would be influenced by dance culture, and I was kind of like, I don't think it's strange at all, you know. It's really, it would be strange if it wasn't, you know. I mean, if Stockhausen was our age, he would have grew up with this music and it would have bled into his music. He didn't, he grew up with whatever he's listening, I don't know, Beethoven or whatever it was. And I don't see why I would go back to Beethoven. I couldn't give a damn about Beethoven. I mean, it means nothing to me at all. It really doesn't mean anything at all to me. I mean, simple. I'll go back to, you know, Groove Rider.